Hello everyone. Today's lecture is going to be a very short one. Equilibrium of particles in 3D. It's going to be a very short one because we already learned everything that is needed to know in order to tackle these problems. Equilibrium of particles in 3D is basically the same as equilibrium of particles in 2D. So we covered that topic already in previous class. So this is going to be just a very, very short lecture, and then we'll do some examples. Let's get to it. So here we have it. For 2D, here, 2D, and for 3D, here, 3D, basically the same thing. We have, for 2D, two basic equilibrium equations. We have a way to find two unknowns. For 3D, we have exactly the same, but we have one extra axis, the Z axis, usually. And we have then three equations, so we can find three unknowns. So remember how we proceed. In the 2D, we decompose the forces in the rectangular components. So we have X and Y components of the forces, X and Y components, and X and Y components. So once you have all the forces in the X and Y components, you set up the two equations, and you solve your unknowns from them. So in 3D will be something like this to get the three components for each force, XYZ. You set up your equations and you solve for your unknowns. Basically, the idea is that you have to get the direction cosines based on the geometry that you have, or the location of some points, the coordinates of some points, to get the position vector. The position vector is no other than the direction cosines of the force. And also remember, sometimes you get the force orientation in a construction like this. They give you these three numbers. And then the unit sine and the cosine of this. You know that the sine of this angle alpha here is equal to 3/5. Or if you need the cosine of that angle, there is 4/5. So sometimes you don't work with the angle, you get with these parameters that are given to you. All right, so nothing else to say. Everything that you need to do this kind of problem, you know it already. So let's get to some examples. Okay, here we have this balloon. It says three cables are used to tether a balloon as shown. The balloon exerts a force of 800 newtons vertical at point A. Determine the tension on each cable. All right. So first thing we have to do a free body diagram of point A. That will be our particle here. Point A will be our particle. To do the free body diagram, we'll remove everything that is around point A. Everything that is touching point A will be removed and will be replaced by the force that every element that we remove exerts over the point A. So here we will have the cables that we will remove. This cable produces a force here, cable AC produces a force here, and cable AB produces a force here over the point A. And there is also the force of the balloon going up. It's called that force P, and it's equal to 800 newtons. So this is the diagram that we are going to do really nice. It has to be very well done in order to produce very good equilibrium equations. So let's do with a very nice size. This is X, this is why this is axis Z. Going up here, this is X, this is Y, this is Z. Now we establish the points, point B over here, point A somewhere over here, point C here somewhere, and point D back in here. Okay, so they draw the forces or the cables first. The cable we don't draw, well, we won't draw the cable like auxiliary lines here, because actually what we need to draw is the forces. Let's do those as auxiliary lines here. This will be AB. There will be the cable AC, and this will be the cable AD. Cable AD. So now we draw the forces. Let's draw force AD. We give it a name, let's call it tension AB. Another force coming down here. This will be tension AC, because this is point B. This is point C. This is point D. And this is force AD. We will call it tension AD. We in the diagram we also put some dimensions, all dimensions that we need in order to set up all the directions. So we have this distance from the origin to from the origin to point D is 3.3. From the origin to point B is 4.2. Then the height of to up to point A is point A is 5.6. And then this distance will be, let's put some auxiliary line here. This distance is 4.2, and this distance is 2.4. Here is 2.4. Okay, that's what we need. So that's our very nice free body diagram. This is the direction of C positive. This is Y positive, and this is X positive. So now we're ready to write our equation. We are going to, I guess the best way to do this equation of equilibrium, that is basically a summation of the components of each force. We have to get the rectangular components of each force. So I'm going to do it here by the method of multiplying the magnitude of the force multiplied by the unit vector in the direction of the force. The direction of the force is the direction of the cables. So let's find the unit vector in the direction of the cables. I'm going to move this a little bit around so we can write all those equations. So here we have cable AB. Let's start with cable AB. AB. And then we can get AB. The vector AB is equal to how we have to move from A to B according to the Cartesian axis. So we have to move 0 in the x direction because A and B are in the plane yz. 0 in the x direction. Then we have to move negative in the y direction, like this distance, which is 4.2. And then we have to go down 5.6. So that will be our AB vector. So it's 0i minus 4.2j minus 5.6k. And then with these coordinates or with these paths, we can get the total length of the cable AB, which would be the square root of 4.2 square plus 5.6 square. This is going to give us 7.0 meters. With this magnitude, we can get the unit vector in the direction AB, which is the vector AB over the magnitude of the vector AB. So it would be 1 over 7 multiplied by 0i minus 4.2j minus 5.6k. That's our unit vector in the direction of the line AB. So TAB, the vector TAB, will be equal to the magnitude TAB multiplied by the direction lambda AB. So that comes to be equal to each one of the components of the lambda multiplied by TAB. So 0 over 7, 0 here, 0 TAB I minus 4.2 over 7 times TAB minus that's 0.6 TAB J minus 5.6 divided by 7 TAB minus 5.6 divided by 7 is 5.8 TABK. So that's the vector TAB or the tension in cable AB in terms of the rectangular components along X, Y, and Z. So let's do the same for the other two cables. So now AB. Let's go for AC, vector AC. In order to move from A to C, according to the axis, we have to move in the X direction 4.2. Then we have to move down, we have to move in the Y direction 2.4. In the y direction, and then we move down in the z direction 5.6. So it's like this. From A to C, we have to go in the x direction, we set 4.2, maybe 4.2i. In the y direction, 2.4, positive, 2.4. In the y direction, and then we did down the z direction 5.6, negative 5.6 because we are going down. 4.2 2.4 5.6. So the total distance from A to C is found by Pythagorean theorem in 3D, square root of 4.2 square plus 2.4 square minus 5.6 square, that will give us 7.4 meters. 7.4 meters. So now to get lambda is a unit vector, so we divide the vector over its magnitude. So it will be 1 over 7.4 multiplied by 4.2i plus 2.4j minus 5.6k. Now that we have that lambda, we can get the vector TAC. So TAC would be the magnitude that we call it TAC, we don't know it yet, multiplied by the unit vector in the direction AC. So that will be equal to the magnitude TAC multiplied by this values here, 4.2 over 7.4, 2.4 over 7.4, 5.6 over 7.4. So we get 4.2 over 7.4 is 0.56757 TAC. Then 2.4 divided by 7.4, that is 0.32432 TAC J minus 5.6 over 7.4, that's -0.75676 TACK. So that is force TAC in terms of rectangular components. Right there. Let's do the last one, AD. In order to go from A to D in the X direction, we move minus 3.3, and then we move up down 7.6, and there is no motion in the y direction. So we have AD, vector AD will be negative 3.3i 0 in the y direction, and negative 5.6 in the z direction. And then we get the length of the cable AD equals to the square root of 3.3 square plus 5.6 square. And that gives us 6.5 meters. 6.5 meters. So now we can get lambda AD. Lambda AD is the unit vector in the direction from A to D. It will be AD vector divided by AD magnitude. And we get 1 over 6.5 meters multiplied by minus 3.3i plus 0j minus 5.6k. That's lambda. Now if we want the tension AD in terms of the components will be the magnitude AD multiplied by lambda AD. So that will be equal to, we do 3.3 divided by 6.5, that's 0.50, negative 0.50769 TAD I plus 0 TAD J minus 5.6 divided by 6.5 is 0.86154 TADK. So we have three forces here: force AB, force AC, force AD. There is one last force. That force is the vertical force here that is said to collect E, 800 newtons going up. So there is one last force here. Let's put it here. E is a force that has zero component in the I direction plus zero component in the J direction plus 800 newtons in the Y direction. Okay, so now that we have everything in rectangular components, we can get our equation, summation of forces in the X, in the Y, and in the Z equals to zero. To do the summation of the components in the X direction, we just have to add this value plus this value plus this value plus this value equals to zero. So let's put that equation over here. Summation of forces in the X direction equals to zero. That will be 0 TAB plus this one right here, 0.56757 TAD plus this one right here, or minus 0.50769. Sorry, this one here is TAC, and this one is TAD. Plus zero for P, so that's all we have in X, in the X direction, so this is equal to zero. Now, summation of forces in the Y direction is equal to zero. Let me get rid of some stuff here, so I won't get confused. So that what do we have? We have in the Y direction, this force, and this force, basically two forces. So it will be 0.6 in the Y, in the J, 0.6 TAB, 0.6 TAB, negative has a negative, minus 0.6 TAB, plus this one here is in the J direction. Oh, where all of them are in the J direction. That's why we don't need to put the J here. These are the components in the J direction. Plus 0.32432 TAC. Plus zero, so no more forces equal to zero. And then summation of forces in the Z direction, equal to zero. So we have, let me get rid of this so we see it more clearly. So now we are going to add this one, K, and K. We have four forces there. So we have minus 0.8 TAB, minus 0.8 DAB. Minus 0.75676 676 676 DAC. Now this one minus 0.86154 TAD plus 800, and those summation has to be equal to zero. We do that summation equal to zero to guarantee equilibrium. So we have our three equations of equilibrium. We just need to solve it. We can use a solver from a calculator or from the website, but it's actually really simple to solve this by hand. Let's do it. So let's call this equation one, equation one, equation two, equation three. So we can do here is that, so this doesn't have TAD, this one doesn't have TAD, so we can replace TAD in terms of TAC here to put it here, and TAB in terms of TAC to put it here, and we can get equation number three in terms of TAC. So it will be, so from equation one, TAD equals two, and it goes to the other side, so it goes 0.56757/0.50769 TAC. TAD, okay. That's equal to 1.11799 TAC. Now from equation two, we have TAB equals two, this goes to the other side positive, so it would be 0.32432/0.6 TAC. So that comes to be 0.54053 TAC. And then putting those results into question three, then we got minus 0.8 TAB. TAB is 0.54053. TAB is 0.54053 TAC. And then put in TAD, this one, this one here, minus 0.75676 TAC. This one right here. And then this one right here, minus 0.86154 TAD, but TAD is this value here, 1.11799 TAC. Right? We are replacing here, right? Plus 800 equals to zero. Well, actually, we can put the 800 on the other side equals to minus 800. All right. We have everything correct here. So we can solve for TAC And TAC will be equal to, TAC will be equal to 800 at the top minus 800 divided by so this is minus 0.8 times 0.5. This is point minus 0.43243, and then this one is minus 0.75676, and these two are 0.96319. Everything multiplied by TAC equals to minus 800. So from here we come to find that TAC is equals to minus 800 divided by minus 2.1474, which is equal to 372.55. Now TAB we get from this equation here, so it will be 0.54053 times TAC. TAC now is 372.55. So this comes to be equal to 201.37. And then TAD from here, TAD will be equal to 1.11799 times 372.55. They will be equal to 416,499,534. So our final solution here with three significant digits will be TAD 201, TAC 373, and TAD 416. So that's the solution. All those numbers are positive because they are just the magnitude of the force. If you want the direction of those, you have to go to the lambdas. Each lambda is giving you the direction of each force. Now you want the angle that each force, well, that will be three angles per force, and you have to go to the cosine, but that's not what we are asking here. The location of the cables is well defined by the dimensions that they have in the problem statement. All right, let's move to another example. Okay, we have here another example. We have an horizontal circular plate that has a weight of 60 pounds and is suspended as shown from three wires that attached to a support at D and for 30 degrees angles with the vertical. We have to find the tension in the wires. All right. A free body diagram on this problem could be something like this. The particle T, three forces going down, that would be the forces on the wires that we can call TA, TB, TC, And there's going to be a reaction here going up of 60 pounds. That will be the whole plate of the whole weight of the plate going down has to go up at the support at the top. However, this free body diagram will be very, very difficult to make, to be clear for all the forces and all the angles that are involved. So I think in this case, it would be more convenient maybe to make some diagrams for each force in order to see the angles easily. Well, we have to set up the equations of equilibrium, which are summation of forces in the x direction equal to zero, in the y direction equal to zero, in the z direction equal to zero. So we have to decompose, we have to find the rectangular components of each force in order to set up these three equilibrium equations. So let's start with tension A. Let's make a little diagram here that is going to help us visualize better the components. If this is the vertical axis here, then let's put the x axis, the c axis, maybe there is a little rotation more in this direction for the c axis, and then the x direction more like this way could help us to see it a little better. This is x. So if this is point A, we can draw this, or let's do the x axis a little longer from the back. So we have the force, this will be the force A up to here, so from here. This is the force A that goes in the direction dA. So it goes down to a point here that generates this line from the origin to A. And we have an angle of 50 degrees here. So this is dA. And if this is 30 degrees, I exaggerated a little bit so you can see it better. Then we can have this line from O to A. This is TA prime. It's like a temporary component of the force TA that is going to allow us to find the components in the x and z direction. This will be an auxiliary line here that allows us to draw here the x component and another auxiliary line here. This is going to allow us to set up here the z component. So this will be T, A, C, and this will be T, A, X. I don't know if you guys see it. We need the X axis here, and the C axis here. So you want to look at the components here, like we are used to on the tail of the force. This will be the component EAZ. This will be here the component. Okay, you see it? Let me put the TAX here. So this is TAX, and this is TAZ, and TAY will be this vertical component going down here, TAY. So you see the components down here at the bottom or at the top, however you look at them better. I don't know what it's easy for you to visualize here. But then again, we have this force TA prime. TA prime is equal to TA sine of 30 degrees. You see it? This is TA prime, and this is the 30 degrees that we're using the sine of this angle in order to get TA prime. It's TA sine of 30 degrees. Now that we have TA prime, this one right here, TA prime, then we can find very easily TAX and TAZ. TAX is equal to TA prime sine of 50 degrees. Is this one, so it is here or the same down there. Okay. So TAX is TA prime sine of 50. And TA prime is TA sine 30. So now multiply by sine 50, and that's TAX. Let's go to TAY so we have it like in order. TAY is equal to simply this one right here going down, TAY cosine of 30 degrees. I hope this is easy for you guys. TA cosine of 30 degrees. And then TAZ, again down to TA prime, is this one right here. TAZ is TA prime sine of 50 degrees. TA prime cosine of 50, right? This one right here is cosine of 50 degrees. Cosine of 50 degrees. So if TA prime is TA sine 30, then we got it from here. Cosine of 50 degrees. Okay. So let me put it here a little bit towards the right. The total vector TA expressed in terms of the components. So we have TAX. TAX is sine 30, sine 50. Sine 30, sine 50. 1, 3, 8, 3, 0, 2. Oh, hold on, before I put that number, you have to check every time in what direction is going this. TAX is going in the negative direction of the axis. So this is negative. TAX is negative. Minus 0.38302 pi TA plus TY. TY is negative also. So it's negative cosine 60, which is 0.86603 J TA. And TC is in the positive direction, so positive is sine 30 cosine 50. Sine 30 cosine 50. That comes to be 0.32139 K TA. All right, so we have one. We have one of the forces in terms of rectangular components. Let's go now for the second one. Okay, so let's make another diagram, the one we just did for the force B. Let's do some axis here. Let's put the Y axis here. Let's put the x-axis going like this way here, so we can see the 40 degrees angle. 40 degrees is here, making 40 degrees with the x-axis. So let's put the x-axis in this direction. And the z-axis is like this one, so we see it right there. See, this would be x, and that would be y. Our auxiliary point here, point B would be somewhere over here, making 40 degrees with the x-axis. So we have this line going OB. This point B here, this point O, and our force T sub B will be something like here. Something like this. So this will be force TB. Some auxiliary lines here, parallel to the axis, so we can get the components. Right, you guys see it? So let's put some angles here. The line OB makes 40 degrees with the x-axis. So that would be this 40 right here on the floor. All the cables make a 30 degree angle here with the vertical, 30 degree. That's why this purple line at the bottom that we call it a TB prime. And this is the one that's going to allow us to find this component here, which is TBZ, and this component here that is TB. X, and the vertical component TBY just goes down here very easy. It's just cosine 30, right? This is TBY. All right, very clear. I hope it's very clear. Probably you guys like to see these components up here. That's what we usually put it, the components of a vector at the tail of the vector. So this one will be TBX and this will be TBZ, right? Okay. Ready? Okay, let's get rid of this guy here, put it down here. We need it for now. So now let's go for TB prime is equal to TB sine 30. I hope everybody sees that. We have TB, this TB, sine 30, give you this TB prime. All right? Now, based on that, we can calculate TBX as TB prime cosine 40, right? Cosine 40. Let me put this label and go on to the other side. This is TBY. Better. So TBX is TB prime, which is this TB sine 30 cosine 40. Now, I'm going to do TBY, so I keep this in order. TBY is very simple. It's the one that we have said several times. That is this cosine 30, because we're talking about this one right here. So TBY is equal to TB cosine 30. TB cosine 30. And then TBZ is the other one that comes from the purple one on the floor, this one right here, multiplied by sine of 40 to get this TBC. So it's T prime, TB prime, sine 40. TB prime sine 40. So TB prime is TB sine 30. This one right here again, sine 40. All right, so we have the three components, so we can express the same way we did with TA. We have here TB. TB can be expressed as TBX, TB sine 30 cosine 40, 0.3802. Is it positive? Is it negative? Okay, X is positive. It's in the positive direction of the x-axis. So it's 0.38302 I TB. The y is negative. All the y's are going down in the y direction, so it's negative cosine 30.86603 J T B. And the z is positive also, goes in the positive direction of the axis, so it's positive sine 30, sine 40. Sine 30, sine 40, 0.32139 K TB. We have two forces decomposed in rectangular components. Let's do the third one. TC. For the TC, that makes 60 degrees with the back of the X axis. So let's put here the Y axis here. Y axis. Let's put the X axis going very down here, so we really see that angle. And then the C, maybe this direction drives like this, could be show a little better than the actual picture. So this is the C positive, and this is the X positive. This is plus X and Y positive. So here we have our point C will be 60, making this line OC 60 degrees with X, so it will be something like over here. So let's draw the purple line that goes from the origin to the point C. Point C here, that makes 60 degrees with X. So this is the 60 degree angle. This is the 60 degree angle that makes here C with X, 60 here. This is the one that with some auxiliary lines here will allow us to see the components in the X and C direction. Oh, this X axis looks horrible, sorry. Oops, worse. Oh, that's not the X axis, that's just, oh, that's the C axis, but the negative C. Negative C. So here you can see the component on the C direction, on the Z direction. Oh, this is gonna be tough to see it here. Oh, Let me increase a little more the angle here with the X, because then the four is not gonna allow us to see. Because maybe a little better here. So it's gonna be something like this. And this one a little more in this direction. So here we have the C component, the X component. This line is a little crooked here. Okay. And then the force TC will be a force like going like this. This is the 30 degree angle. This is the TC force, TC. If you multiply TC by sine of 30, you get the purple line that is the purple component that allowed us to calculate the X and C, which are this one here. This is CZ, and this one is CX. Just by multiplying the purple for cosine of 60 here and sine of 60 here. This purple is the one that we are calling T prime, TC prime. Let's get rid of this one. I guess we can get rid of this for good. I'll put some more auxiliary lines here. We can put a vertical here. Another one here. And then we have this one right here, like this. And this vertical over here. I'll put it like this, and this. This is going to be difficult to show. Let's move the angle one second. It's going to disappear. And then this is the TCX. Another one here. This one is TCZ. Another line that is missing there. I guess that's it. I hope you guys see it. The 30 degree angle that I lost was here. 30 degrees is the angle that TC makes with the vertical axis. The angle that the vertical axis makes with the actual force on the cape. All right. Let's then find TC prime. TC prime is equal to TC sine 30. Based on TC prime, we can find TCX and TCZ. TCX will be TC prime. TC prime cosine 60. So this is equal to TC prime is TC sine 30, cosine 60. Then TCY is just TC cosine 30, TC cosine 30, and TCZ is TC prime sine 30. You can do it like automatic already. TC prime is TC sine 30, sine 60. The 60 is the 60, this TC is this TC. Okay? All right, so we can write down TC vector as a function of the rectangular components. TCX is TCX, so positive 0.25 I TC. The Y direction is always vertical. I didn't draw it. The vertical component is this one coming down right here. It's just TC cosine of 30. So TC for the vertical direction negative. This, oh, I have it here, TC cosine 30 is TC. Cosine 30 is 0.86603 J TC. And the C direction is also negative. This one right here is TC.
TC sine 30 sine 60. Zero point 43301 KTC. Now we have all the forces in terms of their rectangular components. So let's put them here together. TA, TB, TC.
We have already these three forces here. And we are missing this one here. It's another force that we have to decompose in the rectangular components. So that force is the reaction on the bolt here.
Is the force that the wall, the ceiling is applying on the bolt is a vertical force going up of 60 pounds. So we have to decompose this force in the three rectangular components. In this case, it's only just one component. So the composition will be 0 in the x direction, positive 60 in the j direction, and 0 in the z direction. So now we need to set up the equilibrium equations. Once we have all the forces expressed in the rectangular components, we make the summation of the components on each direction. Summation of forces or components in the x direction. That will be summation of all of these components. All the components in the I direction, minus 0.38302 TA. We don't need to write I because all the forces are in the I direction. All the forces are horizontal, following the direction of the X axis. Two in one direction and one in the opposite direction. So we do the summation. Plus 0.38302 TB. We don't write the vector I because this is a summation of scalars, all the magnitudes that go in the direction of the x axis. So we just write the scalars. And this, we have also the component of the TC force, 0.025 TC, and the W, which is the reaction of the total weight on the ceiling, doesn't have component in the X direction, so this summation is equal to zero. Then, same way, we do summation of forces in the Y direction. We add the components in the direction of the y-axis, the j component, 0.86603 TA minus 0.86603 TB minus 0.86603 TC plus 60 equals to 0. We make the summation of all the components equals to 0 to guarantee equilibrium. Now we do the summation of the forces or the components in the z direction or in the k direction. 0.32139 TA plus 0.32139 TB minus 0.43301 TC plus 0 equals to 0. Summation of forces equals to 0. So this is a set of three equations with three unknowns. We can solve this system of equations with any means that we can. For example, we can go on Google and find an application to solve simultaneous system of simultaneous equations. We can solve this by any means we can. We enter the coefficients of the unknowns. In this case, x will be TA, y will be TB, and z will be TZ. And the term to the right in the first equation is 0. 0.38302. Plus 0.25 TC, that will be 0.25YZ, equals to 0. Minus 0.86603X, corresponding to the second equation, minus 0.86603Y, minus 0.86603TC, not equal to 2, and it equal to minus 60. The plus 60 goes from the left side of the equation to the right side of the equation with a negative sign. And equation 3, 0.32139 TA plus 0.32139 TB minus 0.43301 TC equals to 0. Submit, and we have the solution. Of course, you can solve this by any means you can. You can do it by hand, or you can use an application that now is so easy to find on the web, or your calculator, your computer, Excel, anything.
X will be TA.
So TA equals 29.5 pounds. Y will be TB. TB equals 10.3 pounds. And Z will be TC, 29.5 pounds.
All right. Wonderful. This will be our answer right here. All right, these numbers are all positive. It's just the magnitude of the force. The direction is given by the direction cosines, the direction cosines of the of each force, which you have there. When we decompose each one of the forces, what we have there is the direction, the direction cosines of each one of those directions. So the sign, or if it goes positive or negative, is contained within those numbers, those equations, those numbers that you see here. These are the signs that control the direction of the force. And if you want to check this square plus this square plus this square, has to give you a 1. Let the 1 check just one of them, just to see. how it works. 0.38302 square plus 0.86603 square plus 0.32139 square equals 1.000038. All right. Okay, that would be the solution of this problem.